Hello and welcome back to Amulya's Academy YouTube channel. We were discussing Dijkstra's algorithm. Today, let's write a Python program to find shortest distance from a node to all other nodes in the graph using Dijkstra's algorithm. Okay, first let's see the requirements. To write a function to find shortest distance from a node to all other nodes in the graph using Dijkstra's algorithm, we need a graph first. And here we need a weighted graph. Next, we need a starting node. Starting node, or you can call it as source node, will find the distance from this node to all other nodes in the graph. First two requirements are, one is graph. We need a weighted graph. Here we have a graph. Graph is represented using dictionary. These are nodes. We'll use add node function to add node to dictionary, and add edge function with distance. This will represent graph like this, dictionary, and here values are represented using list. First requirement. Second requirement is, we need a starting node. You can take any node of the graph as the starting node. So let's write the function. Use def keyword, then followed by function name. You can take any suitable name. And next here, we need to mention the parameter. As I said, we need graph as well as starting node or source node. Here I'll take this parameter name as start. So that will be the start node or source node. Okay, done. Next, after graph and starting node, we need a distance dictionary. In this algorithm, we need to maintain the minimum distance of every node, right? While explaining the algorithm in the previous tutorial, we saw that we need to store minimum distance of every node. Initially, we'll take source node distance as 0, and for all other node, will assign infinity as the distance, right? For that, to store the distance, we need a dictionary. We'll create a dictionary. In the dictionary, key will be the node of the graph. Every node, we'll mention every node. And value is its distance, minimum distance, right? Initially, it will be infinity. To create this dictionary, for distance, we'll use dictionary comprehension method in the program. This is the syntax of dictionary comprehension. Here we can see an example. So here in our program, what we need is, first we need to create distance. I'll give dictionary name as distance. And here key is nothing but the node of the graph. And for value, I'll take infinity. So for that, I'll use float and inf like this. This is used for infinite value. We need infinity, right? So for that, we need to use this. This float data type provides a built-in way to represent infinity. We can represent like this. So this is the dictionary comprehension method. Let me show you how it actually works. First, take a graph like this. And now if I write this here. And now if I check distance. You can see key of the dictionary is every node of the graph and value is infinity. That's why we'll use this dictionary comprehension method to create this dictionary. Next, I need to take the value of start node, that is the source node, as 0. I need to take the distance, the minimum distance of source node as 0. For that, I'll reassign the value for that distance and start. How to reassign the value in the dictionary? Like this, right? Take key and reassign its value. So distance of start is 0. Done with the distance dictionary. Next step. We need a priority queue. So how to create a priority queue? First, initialize an empty list. Use heap push to add elements to queue. Use heap queue, heap pop, remove and return the smallest element. So here first step is, in the first line, I'll import heap queue to create a priority queue. And here, create a list first. So in this list, what I'll do is, I'll initially add the first element to queue. Initially, we need to add the first element or the source node or the starting node to queue with its distance, right? So here, I'll create a queue and I'll add that node and its distance to queue. I'll do this in the single step, right? This is a tuple. We need to add node and its distance. For that, I'll use tuple like this. And here each tuple contains node and its distance like this. All right. So we are done with the priority queue. Next, what we need to do? First, we need to add the starting node or source node to queue, right? Next step is we need to remove that from the queue. So to remove that from the queue, I need to use heap pop method. So heap queue, heap pop, and here you need to mention queue like this. So if you have any confusion about creating priority queue, here is an example. First, you need to import heap queue, create an empty queue. For heap push, you need to use like this queue, and here you need to mention a priority as well as a task. Heap push like this, and for heap pop, you need to mention the syntax like this. So if I execute this now, here you can see it will execute according to the priority. So first element removed is the element which has priority as 1. That is minimum heap, that's why. Next 2, next 3. If you have any doubt about the priority queue, you can refer this example. Okay, here we need to remove the element from the queue. So we need to use like this heap queue dot heap pop queue. This heap pop method will return the value. What it will return? It will return distance and node. So I need to store that in a variable, and I'll take it as current distance and current node. So this heap pop method will return distance and node. I'll store that it as current node and current distance. We'll add this tuple to queue, right? So when we remove the element from the queue, we'll get distance and node. I'll take it as current node and current distance. Next, we need to find the neighbors of this current node, and we need to update its distance, right? So to get the neighbors of the current node, I need to use graph of current. Graph is a dictionary. To get its value, we need to use this key and we need to get that node. Graph of current node here. Just for an example, initially, if starting node is A, then we'll get A here as current node. Then we need to get its neighbor. For that, graph of A, like this. And a node can contain more than one adjacent node, right? To get every adjacent node one by one, we'll use for loop like this. Okay, here also, value of the dictionary is adjacent node and its weight, right? Here you can see, value is nothing but adjacent node and its weight. So we need both. That's why here I'll use two variables, node and weight. So node will represent adjacent node. Weight is its edge weight. We'll get node and weight. Then what we need to do? We need to find the new distance. I'll take a variable new distance. How to find new distance? Current distance plus weight. In the previous tutorial, we used this formula, right? Using this current distance, we need to find the new distance. We need to add current distance and weight. So we'll get current distance here, and for weight here, we'll get weight, edge weight here. So we need to add that. And next we need to check whether new distance is smaller than the already recorded distance. For that, if new distance is smaller than the distance recorded in the this dictionary, distance of node, here we'll get one adjacent node. First, we need to find a new distance, and we need to check whether that new distance of that node, adjacent node, is less than the recorded distance for that node. Recorded distance will be here in this dictionary, in the key and value pair, node and distance. So to get that distance, we need to use this. So by using this, we'll get its value, that is nothing but distance, and we'll compare it with the new distance. If new distance is smaller, then we need to update distance in that dictionary. Because here in this dictionary, we want all the smallest distance. We need smallest distance for a node. So for that, we need to use this. Here, let's update the new distance. If new distance is smaller, then assign that to that node. Assign that distance as the minimum distance of that node. So update it. And also, we need to add that to heap. Here you need to mention queue, that is the queue name. followed by a tuple. Here you need to mention new distance. We need to add that to Q, right? With distance, and we need to add that adjacent node with its new distance to Q. So we need to use this. And we need to do this, that is, remove the node from the queue, find its adjacent node, find new distance, and if that new distance is smaller than the recorded distance, then update the distance and add that to queue. We need to do this process again and again until queue becomes empty. So we need to include this code inside a loop. So for that, here we need to use a loop called while queue. So until queue becomes empty, perform this. So here, until queue becomes empty, we need to perform this task. We need to execute this part of code. Okay, so now we are done. Here, after while loop, when queue becomes empty, we'll have the shortest distance of all the nodes. So we need to return that. So return distance. That is the dictionary which contains smallest distance for every node. Okay, now we are done. Here, let's call that function. Let's print, because that function returns some value, we need to print that. So call that function with graph and take starting node. I'll take starting node as A. Let's save this and execute this. So here we can see A0, B1, C4, D4, E8, F7, G6, H7 and I7. This is the graph which we took in the previous tutorial as the example. So we got the same distance, right? So this is the output. And here we can add one more condition here. That is, after removing a node from the queue, we can check its current distance with the recorded minimum distance of that node. Here, after removing a node from the queue, we'll get current distance and current node, right? If that current distance is greater than the recorded distance of that node, then no need to check for its adjacent node. We'll calculate the new distance using current distance, right? If current distance is already greater than the recorded distance, then no need to check for new distance, right? Of course, we'll get the new distance which is greater than the recorded distance, because already current distance is greater than the recorded distance. So for that, here you can include a condition. Here you can check if current distance greater than distance of current node, the recorded distance. If it is greater, then skip that iteration. So for that, I'll use continue. So it will stop the execution of next lines. Control will again go here. It will remove another node from the queue. So now if I execute this, it won't change anything here, but it can skip few iterations. And also, what if I mention the starting node as a node which is not present in the graph, like X? So here we'll get error like this. To solve that situations, you can add a condition here. If start not in graph, print a message and return. So now if I execute this, it will print this message, X not in graph. And also here, instead of printing this message like this, you can write like this also. And here, you can print shortest distance like this also. Okay, so this is about Dijkstra's algorithm to find the shortest distance from a node to all other nodes in the graph. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.